Good morning.
Good morning.
Happy Equinox.
Yeah.
Happening tonight, like, I think it's like 6 or 7. So, you know, in the yoga tradition, these times are very potent energetically for us to do our yoga practices and just align more and more with ourself and our sense of being, you know, and our truth. And Kundalini yoga is so much about Sat Nam. Sat is our truth, Nam is our identity. So the truth of who we are. You know, and I say that all yogas really are about connecting to the truth of who you are. And, you know, because ultimately that's that place of coming to wholeness, of that deep contentment, that santosha that we talk about in the yoga scriptures, the ananda, the bliss that we have. It's just, is said to bubble up, that we find it when we come to that place where we've cleared out all the, you know, the stories and all the, you know, the stuff, the emotions, the thoughts, and all the stories that, you know, keep us from just that present moment, that bliss that we can have. And, you know, I think for many of us, we struggle with that, right? We're like, oh, yeah, that's great. But then where is it? You know, where? How do I get to that place? And in my experience, Kundalini yoga is just such an incredibly fast and potent way to get to that place. And we have a 2-hour journey here. And we're going to do a whole spectrum. So we're going to do... We're just going to do a whole spectrum. So we'll do a Kriya that's more physically focused. And then we'll do a little bit of breath work. So specifically practices that work with pranayama, that work with our pranic body. And in that case, it's the breath. And then we're going to end with a very long 31-minute chanting, which is pretty trancy. And it's very specific. We love it. It's our favorite, one of our all-time favorite meditations. And we'll do it with the music, and we'll go somewhere for sure. And we just thought it would be quite auspicious on the equinox to do this chant. So we're very excited. And so for those of you who are new, you know, or anybody, just, you know, take it as it goes. Do what you can. You may feel you know, test it a bit. Maybe your mind will go somewhere where you're just like, oh, I don't want to do this anymore, or whatever, or your body's kind of hitting a little bit of a wall. So the important thing is, you know your body, and if there's something that feels funky or feels like it's not, you know, you're gonna do something that's gonna hurt yourself, then you just pull back or you stop. Now, if you are just kind of getting frustrated or you're feeling tired or whatever, you know, just see if you can push your limitations, you know, with your breath, with the mantra. We'll use practice of mantra through this. So just see what you can do, you know. Some of these practices are specifically there to try to poke and provoke you, as Yogi Bhajan would say. And because he said this is a practice grab, life is, you know, the true test. And so he said, just practice here so that you're not a mess out there. Yeah. Right? That's part of the practice. And so he said, Kundalini yoga is so much about strengthening our nervous system so that when we get into the world and with all these changes happening on the planet, that we don't fry out. You know, that we're strengthening ourselves, we're strengthening our vibrancy, our auras, so that just from our energetic field, we're already creating more of a protective boundary. You know, so we're not just getting barraged by so much, you know, we don't even comprehend how many, like, frequencies are just constantly buzzing around us, from cell phone towers to who knows what else, right? So there's so much happening in this day and age. And he said, this is the yoga, you know, that is going to help you so much to be able to, you know, really thrive in the times and then to help others, because maybe other people don't have these different yogi technologies to help us. So be vibrant, help us be, come back to our true nature, Sat Nam. Okay, with that said, let's rub our palms together. And create a little warmth, a little friction, and then come sitting up straight. Hands at the center of the chest, eyes are closed. Thumbs just pressing into the sternum. And focusing, projecting out of the third eye. And we're going to chant the mantra, Om Namo Guru Dev Namo. So we're chanting that three times, Om Namo Guru Dev Namo. And that's, I'm just bowing, or I'm in deep reverence for Om, the infinite creative vibrational field that is present and creating all that is. And the Guru Dev, that teacher, the divine teacher that's always with us at all times, that we can just tune into. So we're tuning into that right now. So let's close our eyes, inhale deeply. Exhale. Inhale to tune in.
Om.
Circles, and you'll just, through this practice, you'll just keep your eyes closed, and you'll just internalize your practice. And the eyes are focused up at the center of the brow, just a little bit above where the eyebrows would come together, stimulating that sixth chakra, the frontal lobe, and the pituitary gland. Long deep breaths. Just warming up the spine, massaging the digestive organs. Tip of the tongue, just press up against the roof of the mouth. This is an ancient mudra that is just helps to seal the energy, it helps calm the mind and connect the mind to the body. In this practice of Kundalini Yoga, we use the mantra Sat and Nam. So Sat as we inhale, Nam as we exhale. This is just a mental recitation. calling, an invocation to just the truth of who you are. Beyond all the stories, beyond all the identifications of who you think you are. All the things that people think you are. Serenaded by the lovely Jaya Lakshmi. Just let the music permeate into your every cell. It'll help with your mind, especially with the hard ones. Okay, come center. Nice straight spine. Inhale. Squeeze at the root of the spine. So you're going to tuck the tailbone under. You're going to squeeze at the base, the perineum. Mulban. Root lock. Exhale. Holding on to the knees still, we'll just do a spinal flex. Chest comes forward, chest goes back. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, goes back. Inhale, mentally chanting Sat. Exhale, mentally chanting Nam. So the head stays relatively still. It's more like an African dance kind of movement where you're undulating the chest forward, undulating the chest back, curling the spine. So the middle spine is getting worked here.
To the light.
Inhale, straight spine, squeeze the biceps. You can apply root lock, apply navel lock so that the stomach comes in and up, and then chin lock so the chin comes down in slightly, squeezing the biceps. This is Maha Bandha. Maximizing the pranic intake through the breath. Okay? And we're going to lift up the arms, fingertips in the pads of the hands, thumbs arching towards each other about 60 degrees. So this opens up the lower cavities of the lungs. And we close the eyes down. We focus at the third eye. We project and have the crown center just blasting open here. And we begin breath of fire. Excellent. Relax. up. This was kind of a nice spinal flex, spinal series. And now we're moving into a specific Kriya for the pituitary gland. And so we're going to move right into a lunge. So go ahead and it doesn't really matter which one you bring. We'll switch. So you can bring your left foot forward or your right foot forward, whichever one feels good first. So just come into a lunge. That looks like something like this. Okay. Runner's lunge. And tired, you bring your knee down. It's fine, no biggie. We're going to do the first minute with long deep breathing and then last two with breath of fire, okay? If you can keep your leg up, obviously better. Side, and you put your head to the earth. If there's a little too much tension there, you can bring a block forward, and you can put your head on the block, or if you want, you can put your bolster. If you have that bolster, you can put your bolster so you're a little higher, depending on your body types here. Guess what? 3 more minutes. Long, slow, deep breathing. Here, restorative here. Smelling something really foul, like some exhaust, you know? And then you take a sweet breath of maybe crisp mountain air. Oh, how beautiful it is. Just go into that deep appreciation for your breath, for your lungs, for all the energy that you get just from the air. How much life force do you get from just the air? actually scientifically proven. You need about 3 minutes to really start stretching the ligaments, muscles. So we're just opening up, hang forward, what feels comfortable. Again, if you need a little more support, you can break blocks. You can support yourself higher. Just go ahead, forward stretch. We'll be here for 3 minutes. Long deep breathing. Gentle set, so we went gentle for the equinox. feet are shoulders width apart. Arms come up to not so much like a 45, you're going to a 60 degree angle. And again, you're coming into this pose that we did earlier where the thumbs are going to be sticking up, arching. And this one, we're just doing long, deep breathing. And you get it, the theme, there's a 3 minute theme here. So we're going to do our best to stay here for 3 minutes. Eyes closed, focus the third eye, and just breathe. You can visualize your aura, your energetic field expanding. So Yogi Bhajan taught when the specific pose you can do sitting, you usually do it at a 60 degree angle. Standing, doing less. Do more like a parallels. Nice posture and alignment.
Good.
Use this time practice nice proper alignment.
Fingers rooted into the earth, spread wide. You know,
put a lot of pressure in that pointer finger, pad of the pointer finger. If you need a little support, you can always put something underneath your heels, like you can put a blanket underneath your heel. One of the blocks. We're gonna be here. Guess how long?
3 minutes.
3 minutes. Gosh. A students. Here we go. Long deep breathing. Hold it. To your stomach. Just come forward. Just lay on your stomach. We'll be here for just a minute, relaxing. Shoulders flat on the earth. We're going to rise up in the cobra pose. Just be gentle with your spine. See where you're at this morning. Maybe a gentle sphinx is where you're going to be at today. You can get that? Rise up. And we're going to do long deep breathing here for 1 minute. And then for the second 2 minutes, we're going to be doing a little twist of the head. Inhale left, exhale right. For now, we're just going 1 minute in cobra pose, or maybe sphinx pose is where you're at this morning. You just bring the hands here. Wherever you can do. Wherever your spine is at. Okay? A little, release the spine. Great job. Adjust your knees as feels good for you. And just keep that motion going. It's a nice fluid movement. And you can just go into a deep appreciation, reverence for your life, your bodies, this earth, this yoga studio. Practice right now is just go with gratitude and make every thought gratitude. Make every thought that you're going to have right now reverent. Great training for the mind. Start with 3 minutes, but then we'll work our way up to 24 hours. 7 days a week, 365 days a year, just gratitude and reverence. And then you will be my teacher.
Thank you. everything that we've experienced.
Thank you.
last inhale. Exhale, relax the hands. Gently make your way onto your back. Connect your breath to the bottoms of the feet, palms of the hands together. Bring the knees to the chest, rock the spine front and back. Sitting straight. You have a bolster or a blanket, you want to prop yourself up. And find yourself in a comfortable seating position. And knuckles are touching, thumbs are touching, and they're about right around the heart center. Thumbs are sticking up. Let's see. So there you go. Perfect. Yeah. Good. Right. Knuckles, thumbs. All right, so this is we're gonna do a quick little breath work before we go into the chanting practice. And the breath is just in through the nose, out through the mouth, in through the mouth, out through the nose. Okay, so it's very simple, in through the nose, out through the mouth, in through the mouth, out through the nose. And eyes are 1/10 open. If you can, focus them at the tip of the nose. If that's just too much, then you just, you look down and keep your eyes almost closed. And this practice in particular is for self-animosity. And I'll just read you the description as we go into it, but let's just go ahead and start. We're going to be on 3 minutes, and let's just begin. Inhaling through the nose, exhale through the mouth, into the mouth, exhale through the nose. So Yogi Bhajan was the teacher who brought over this style of Kundalini yoga. And this is what he said about this. There are no enemies. There are challenges to our creativity. The greatest enemy is the self. Self-defeating activity and self-animosity occur where we do not accept ourselves. We instinctively reject self-confirmed continuity. We will oppose our own success and accomplishment just to break with steadiness. That break is the assertion of ego, an attempt at marking and possessing something in time and space. The self-animosity distracts us from the real gift of human life, the capacity to confront and experience the self in relationship to the unknown infinity of ourselves. So this meditation conquers the state of self-animosity and gives you the ability for constant consciousness and support of the core self.
Thank you.
way up to 22 minutes. So that's something that you liked, or you'd like to work on, then please take this practice and integrate it into your own daily sadhana. Self-animosity is such a destructive pattern that I think pretty much all humans carry. At some point, there's this self-destruction that takes place, whether it's with projects you have, relationships, just your daily battle with yourself to truly love yourself. And it's like we're constantly identifying with the body as ourselves. So if the body isn't what we would want it to be, it's incredible, destructive thought tendency, emotional tendencies. And yet, we're just visitors in this body. Here is a yogic practice for you. If you feel inspired, take it. And just perhaps, maybe just lessen to, maybe it completely eliminates any self-animosity. Of course, it takes work. The legend said, you know, you need to do it at least for 40 days to start a new habit. 90 days to really allow that practice to integrate. 120 days to really get to a place of full integration, and 1,000 days for complete mastery. I would like to speak with you after 1,000 days if you did this. Let's see where you're at. Yoga is an alchemy. Yoga is a complete dedication into a practice of seeing what will take place. Kundalini yoga is now practiced probably by millions of people globally. And the practices work. But it's really up to you and your dedication to what degree that they're going to integrate and work for you. And I've been practicing for, I guess, close to 12 years, and daily. And this practice has completely transformed my life. With that said, you know, I'll do practices, and I'll be like, well, what's going on? You know, of course, the mind wants to, is this even working? And we have to dedicate, we have to just see what happens, and we have to be unattached. I mean, because what if it did work? Amazing. And if it doesn't work, guess what? You still just calmed yourself down. Use this breath work just to calm the mind a bit. To just focus on your breath. Be present a little more. But if it does work, just imagine if you have a little less or completely lose that part of your mind chatter that's just constantly beating on yourself. That's sabotaging your relationships, sabotaging your career. Anyways, that's enough on that one. The next one we're going to do, since we worked on self-animosity, now we're going to build up. And this one is particularly beautiful for balancing the energies of the masculine and feminine. Yogi Bhajan specifically gave it for the architect aspect of our minds. And so it's really a potent chant and practice to really just call in a whole new level to your creativity, a whole new level to any artistic or financial or career or just home, whatever it is. It's the architect of your mind. This is just going to take it to a whole new level. And we're going to do the 31 minutes here on the Equinox. So we're going to call in balance for the masculine and feminine. We're going to call in a whole new level of just centeredness and expansiveness for any project that you're going to endeavor on. And the beautiful thing about Kundalini Yoga is you do this practice and then you go out into the world and you don't know what's going to unfold for you, because you're literally unlocking new potentials to your creativity, because that's what Kundalini is. Kundalini is the infinite creative consciousness that is lying dormant unless we activate it, unless we work with it. And then we are infinitely creative beings. You know how there is. Maybe you're like that, or you know people, you're just like, how could you possibly be that creative? Like, how is it that everything you do or whatever, it's just constantly, the creativity is just incredible, flowing. And we can just keep taking that to another level, another level, another level, another. We're unlimited beings. So this is the practice of being unlimited and tapping into your unlimited consciousness. And not only that, but it's so beautiful because we're centering, the idea is to center the whole thing, you know, into a very heart-centered practice. And so the mudra is here at the heart, bringing the hands centered and balanced. Spine straight. And the mantra is ra, 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 ma, 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 ma. So there's the ra, ma, this masculine, feminine, sun, moon. Rama, 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 Rama. So merging the two. And then sa, ta, na, ma. We've done this one. Sa, na. The breakdown of sa, na. Sa, ta, na, ma. So integrating into the truth of our being. So I know some of you have taken the class, we've done it before, but now we have to do 31 minutes. Okay, I'm going to hop on the guitar now, and we'll just go for a nice little journey. So set yourself up, stretch your legs out. We're going to be here for 31 minutes, so stretch it out, get ready. So once you're in, the idea is to lock yourself in. And just stay with it. Don't let your mind go into all the different places that it might want to go. With the chant.
Sometimes during this meditation I have that very cosmic. A lot of times it comes because Ra is the energy of the sun and the Ma is the moon and Ra is so we're creating this kind of tauric energy between the sun and the moon, and I was just going to say, let yourself expand sometimes into that kind of vision. And you know, where the earth is in the equinox right now, like how we're positioned, you know, our planet is positioned there, like in the middle, right, as the equinox is in the solstice, we're kind of in between. So I don't know if you have that kind of visual on that. It's just nice to kind of let it go out into the cosmos a bit.
straight. Hands at the center of the chest. Got the timer going. Not yet. One, coming back from the rest. Eyes are closed, focus at the third eye. And I'll guide you a little bit too as we're going through the practice. Ra 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 ma 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 ra ma ra ma ra ma ra ma sa ta na ma.